In this video, we're going to talk about the origin story of J. Robert Oppenheimer, the father of the atomic bomb. So before starting this video, please like this video and subscribe to our channel for future updates. J. Robert Oppenheimer was a theoretical physicist from the United States. Oppenheimer was the director of the Los Alamos Laboratory during the Manhattan Project and was in charge of the study and design of an atomic bomb. He is often regarded as the father of the atomic bomb. By the time the Manhattan Project began in the fall of 1942, Oppenheimer had already established himself as a world-class theoretical physicist and had gotten deeply involved in researching the feasibility of an atomic bomb. He had spent the previous year conducting research on fast neutrons, calculating how much material would be required for a bomb and how efficient it would be. Despite Oppenheimer's lack of leadership experience and a troubled history with communist causes, General Leslie Groves acknowledged his remarkable scientific brilliance. The United States launched two atomic bombs on Japan less than 3 years after Groves appointed Oppenheimer to lead weapons development. Oppenheimer proved to be an exceptional choice as director of the Los Alamos Laboratory. Oppenheimer was married to Kitty, a botanist. Peter and Tony were their two children. Here, briefly describe the origin story of J. Robert Oppenheimer, the father of the atomic bomb. Let's start. Number 1. Early life. On April 22, 1904, Oppenheimer was born. Oppenheimer's family was a member of the Ethical Culture Society, an extension of American Reform Judaism created and managed by Dr. Felix Adler at the time. Progressive culture prioritized social fairness, civic duty, and secular humanism. In addition, Dr. Adler established the Ethical Culture School, where Oppenheimer attended in September 1911. Oppenheimer's scholastic talent was evident from an early age, and by the age of 10, he was studying mineralogy, physics, and chemistry. His contact with the New York Mineralogical Club was so advanced that the society invited him to give a talk despite the fact that Robert was only 12 years old. He graduated as valedictorian of his high school class in 1921, but was forced to postpone his enrollment at Harvard due to a near-fatal episode of dysentery. His parents arranged for him to spend the summer of 1922 in New Mexico, a refuge for health seekers, after he had been bedridden for months. Robert resided at a guy ranch 25 miles northeast of Santa Fe with his high school instructor and mentor, Herbert Smith. From there, he went on 5 or 6 day backcountry horseback rides. Oppenheimer's health was restored, and he developed a strong attachment to the desert high country. In September 1922, Oppenheimer enrolled at Harvard. He completed his studies in 3 years, excelling in a wide range of topics. Oppenheimer eventually recognized that physics was his actual love. Oppenheimer began his graduate studies in physics at Cambridge's Cavendish Laboratory in 1925. J.J. Thomson, who had won the Nobel Prize in Physics in 1906 for discovering the electron, consented to accept Oppenheimer as a pupil. Oppenheimer learned at Cavendish that his talent lay in theoretical physics rather than practical physics, and he accepted an invitation to study with Max Born, director of the Institute of Theoretical Physics at the University of Göttingen, in Germany. Oppenheimer was fortunate to be in Europe during a critical juncture in the history of physics, when European physicists were creating the revolutionary theory of quantum mechanics. In 1927, Oppenheimer got his doctorate and accepted positions as a professor at the University of California, Berkeley, and the California Institute of Technology. Dr. Oppenheimer was a great nuclear physicist with a thorough understanding of his subject, as well as a cultivated scholar, a humanist, an eight-language linguist, and a brooding seeker of ultimate spiritual ideals. And, from the moment the test bomb burst in Alamogordo, New Mexico, he was tormented by the consequences for man of unleashing the fundamental forces of the universe. Ernest Lawrence, one of the world's finest experimental physicists and the inventor of the cyclotron, became a close friend of his at Berkeley. Number 2. Later years. Following the war, Oppenheimer worked as an advisor to the Atomic Energy Commission, advocating for international armaments control. Oppenheimer managed the Institute for Advanced Study in Princeton, New Jersey, beginning in 1947, where he brought together prominent scientists. We explain to each other what we don't comprehend. During the Second Red Scare, his security clearance was terminated in 1954 during a hearing. Oppenheimer's past communist inclinations were uncovered, and his clearance was terminated 32 hours before it was due to expire. Oppenheimer had created political enemies by opposing the development of the hydrogen bomb, and removing his clearance removed him from political influence. The scientific community was incensed by Oppenheimer's treatment and despised Edward Teller, who testified against him at the tribunal. Please read Oppenheimer's security hearing for additional information. In 1960, he founded the World Academy of Art and Science with Albert Einstein, Bertrand Russell, and Joseph Rotblat. He continued to lecture around the world after receiving the Enrico Fermi Award in 1963. In 1967, he died of throat cancer. Batman is possibly the most well-known superhero whose debut appearance did not feature his origins. In 1961, he declared of the atomic bombings of Hiroshima and Nagasaki, "I have no weight on my mind. Scientists are not criminals," he stressed. "Our work has transformed the conditions under which mankind live, but how these changes are used is a concern for governments, not scientists." Dr. Oppenheimer achieved the pinnacle of his career at the age of 41, with the detonation of the first three atomic bombs and the immediate Allied victory in World War II. He was dubbed the father of the atomic bomb, and the War Department formally recognized him with achieving the deployment of atomic energy for military purposes. The development of the bomb was primarily attributable to his ingenuity, as well as the inspiration and direction he provided to his colleagues. Dr. Oppenheimer was awarded a Presidential Citation and a Medal of Merit for his leadership of the Los Alamos Laboratory, where the bomb was constructed, shortly after. That's it for today. We hope you found our video interesting. If you did, please give it a big thumbs up and share it with others. Also, if you haven't already, please consider subscribing to our channel. Don't forget to turn on the notification bell so you don't miss any of our new uploads. In the end, thanks for watching, and see you next time.